Hi, here's a tutorial on using the method of joints to analyse a triangulated structure, or a pin-jointed frame. That's a structure that's made up predominantly of triangles, which is a very stable, light structure. There are a lot of things you need to think about when using the method of joints, and I've written down five of the steps, the key steps, that we're going to run through in this tutorial. So, the first thing we need to do is model the structure, and here is a structure that's been modelled. It looks a little bit like a dockyard crane. It's leaning over and carrying about a 5-ton load. That's about 50 kilonewtons. And although this is a good starting point, I've decided on the supports and the sizes. I need to draw a free body diagram as a base diagram for the analysis. So I'm going to draw a free body diagram, and that's incredibly similar to the initial model. There's a slight difference in that the I don't show the support types, I just show the restraint forces. Okay, so I'm going to assume that I've got a restraint force here. This is a pinned support, so it restrains the structure in two directions. This is a horizontal roller support, so it just restrains the structure in one direction. Got a load here of 50. I'm going to assume that all forces are in kilonewtons. Great. What I need to do now is label up my structure. And I need to label up these forces that I don't know what they are. So for the reaction A, I'm going to call this the vertical part of the reaction VA, and HA for the horizontal component of the reaction forces, and then E is just a vertical force, so I'll call that VE. Fabulous. I've got my structure model. I've got a free body diagram, which now shows all the forces acting on the entire structure. And I'm going to use that as my base diagram. Let's check the lengths. Yeah, 4 meters, 4 meters. Yeah, everything's just about 4 meters. Can't go wrong with this. And because all the sides are 4 meters, well, when I come to check the angle of one of these diagonals, 4 meters, 4 meters, I know that that's going to be 45 degrees. Right, I think I'm set to do the next step. The next step is to check for mechanisms. That's quite a simple step. Checking for mechanisms more or less means looking for any shapes that aren't triangular. If you end up with a square, a rectangle, a pentagon, anything like that, that should ring alarm bells. This is a nice simple shape made up of three triangles, so we're okay for mechanisms. Check for statical determinacy. The way we're going to do that is by using the little formula m plus r minus 2j equals 0. When m members are restraint forces, J joints. So let's have a look here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 members. 1, 2, 3 restraint forces. And the number of joints, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 minus 2 times 5, and that equals 7 plus 3 is 10, 2 times 5 is 10. Equals 0. So it's statically determinate, and as it's statically determinate, that means that I can make use of the three equations of statics for a structure that's in equilibrium, and we're hoping that this is going to be in equilibrium. And all that means is that when I sum all the vertical forces, they all add up to 0. When I sum all the horizontal forces, they all add up to 0. When I sum all the moments acting on the structure, they all add up to 0. So they're the three equations of statics that we're going to use to analyse this structure. So the first thing I want to do now is to calculate the reactions. I've got three restraint forces here. The way I'm going to do that is by taking moments about one of the two supports. Taking moments about A looks a good start, so that's what I'm going to do. Put this here, we can see what we're doing as we go along. So if I take moments about A, I'm going to say clockwise is positive. Put my finger on A and I'll look for any other forces. Well, there's a couple here, 50 kilonewtons. And that force is acting at a distance of, 8 meters. And if that force were to go around A, it would go around in a clockwise direction. So I'm saying that's positive. So I've got a force VE, and that's acting at a distance of 4 meters. Now that's going to be going around point A in an anti-clockwise way, so I'm going to make that minus. There are a couple more forces here, HA and VA, but they both run straight through point A. And as that's the case, as the line of action of these forces passes through that point around which I'm taking moments, their moment is going to be zero because their distance from that point is zero. So I add up all my moments and it all comes to zero. So I have 50 times 8, so that's plus 400 minus 4VE, and it all adds up to zero. I want to get the VE on the other side of the equation to the 400, so I'll add it to both sides. So 400 equals 4VE. Now I just flip the two sides over and divide by both sides by 4. So VE equals 400 over 4, which equals 100 kilonewtons. Bingo. I go back to my base diagram and add this on. VE equals 100 kilonewtons. Okay, that's a good start. Now I want to find the other two reactions at HA and VA. So I'm going to take moments about E. So let's take moments about E. Again, clockwise positive. I take moments about E. Let's have a look, put my finger on E and look for some other forces. Well, I've got VA, yep, and this 50 kilonewton force, and HA, well, that line of action passes through E, so I can forget it. Same with VE, that's passing through there. So let's add these two forces on. So I've got 50 times that force is acting at a distance of 4 meters away, and it's going to be clockwise, so it's positive. This force VA is also acting 4 meters away, and it's also going to be clockwise. So VA times 4, and that's positive. And the whole thing is going to add up to zero. Now I've assumed that VA is acting upwards. I may not be right, I may be right, who knows, we're going to find out in a minute. It really doesn't matter at this stage if my assumptions are right or wrong, because I can go back and change this diagram. Let's work this through. 50 times 4 is 200. 4 times VA plus 4VA equals 0. I've got to get VA on the other side of the equation, or rather I'll move 200 over, that makes more sense. 4VA equals minus 200. Therefore VA equals minus 200 over 4, which equals minus 50. Okay, well, I'm happy that VA is 50 kilonewtons, I can understand that. But what is a minus force? Well, a minus sign simply tells me that I've assumed the wrong direction for the force. It's not acting upwards, the minus tells me that it's acting downwards. Now, normally I'd do this in pencil and I just rub this out and change it. But here I'm going to hatch that out. Change the direction of the force. That's nice and clear now, and it kind of makes sense that this structure is almost a bit like a children's seesaw. As I pull down on this side tends to lift up, so the restraint force has to pull it down. Okay, so I worked out two reactions. I can now find the horizontal force at A. That's HA. How do I find that out? Well, I could take moments about some point, but the easiest way would be to resolve horizontally. So I'm looking at all the forces acting horizontally on the structure. So resolve horizontally, and I've got HA, and there are no other forces acting on the structure. Therefore HA is going to equal zero, no horizontal forces acting on the structure. So draw that in, zero. Great, so I've got my three reactions, I've got my free body diagram, and Now I can make a start analysing the structure. Now, I think I'll start. I have to start at one joint and move to across the structure joint by joint. I'm going to start at joint A because that looks nice and simple. And the way I'm going to start at joint A is to draw it out nice and neatly. Right, let's draw it out. So joint A, draw it out to a reasonable size so I can see what I'm doing. HA is 0, add all the information I know about the joint, and VA is 50. This member here is FAB, FAB vertical, and this member here is FAE, FAE. Okay. How am I going to deal with this? I've only got three ways I can approach this. As we looked at the very start, I can resolve vertically, and all the forces add up to zero. Resolve horizontally, all the forces add to zero. Or I can take moments. Well, I don't generally take moments when I'm using the method of joints. So really, I'm just down to using one of these two equations, which are the equations of statics. And the reason I can use that is that I've drawn a free body diagram of just joint A. So as long as I have the exposed internal forces within these two members added to the diagram, and I add all the external forces, it's got to be in equilibrium, because every part of this structure is in equilibrium. I can chop any part of it, and as long as I add in all the necessary forces, it'll be in equilibrium. Great. Okay. So here, I'm going to either resolve vertically or horizontally. Let's start off resolving vertically. So I resolve vertically. If I say upwards is positive, then I start off with a minus 50. And let's assume that FAB is acting upwards, plus FAB equals 0. Therefore, FAB equals 50. Great. And I know that it's acting upwards. And now I'll go back to add this onto my base diagram. 50 kilonewtons acting upwards. Well, if that's pulling upwards, remember AB must be in tension. And if you've got an elastic band in tension, that pulls at both ends equally. So this member's in tension, it must also be pulling in tension at its opposite end of B. Great. Let's have a look at resolving horizontally now. So I'll resolve horizontally for this joint. And again, I'll say positive to the right. I won't necessarily draw these out every time. This is quite an easy way to resolve horizontally. In fact, you don't really need any maths for this. If there are no horizontal forces acting on the joint, you know that FAE has got to be 0. Great. As soon as I know that, I add it onto my base diagram, FAE 0. Well, that's joint A out of the way.